Welcome to Tweet of the Week. And today we have the distinct pleasure of recognizing one of our amazing elementary school principals who has actually been recognized by the National Association of Elementary School Principals as a 2020 National Principal of the Year. So congratulations, Mr. Troy Barnes from Monocacy Elementary School. We are incredibly proud of you. We know how well deserving this award is. And as a superintendent, I have a particularly selfish reason for being excited when staff get recognized on the national level, because we get to bask in the glory of your award. And they say, gee, those people in FCPS have really talented people working for them. And we know that, but we like when the national spotlight is shined on that. So congratulations, Troy.
Thank you.
And this award was announced in the spring, and I know we did a lot of celebrating with you on Twitter. And typically then the national organization does a celebration. So when are you slated to have this national celebration as a Principal of the Year?
So the Principal of the Year award was supposed to be held in DC. I think it was this month, and it was moved to July in Chicago. So the event will take place in July, and I think it's the NAESP National Conference that it'll take place.
Okay. So we've seen a lot of award celebrations that have gone virtual, so it's interesting that this organization wants to try to wait and see. And I guess that's what you'll do. You'll wait and see if it turns out to be a virtual or a live event. So, Troy, do you know who nominated you for the award? Was it your peers? Was it your staff?
Tracy Hilliard, principal, nominated me, which was more humbling and appreciative than even the award itself, coming from her, who I highly respect and admire. So it meant a lot coming from Mrs. Hilliard, and more so than even the award.
And I think a lot of people feel that way when it's a peer nomination, because you work so hard, and when your colleagues recognize that, it means a lot. And I think in just a few minutes of talking to you about what's going on at Monocacy Elementary School, anybody watching this is going to know why you got this award. So we'll take you into your comfort zone,
okay.
Troy, and we'll let you talk about what are the exciting things going on at Monocacy Elementary School right now.
So, we just have a phenomenal staff that puts students first. We are in the communities on at least a biweekly basis, passing out school supplies, providing resources. We have staff that have aligned and worked with the I Believe in Me to pass out food. We're getting shots into the community. So anytime we ask, our staff is amazing, and they show up and support our community. They're also willing to provide face-to-face instruction with our students, and we continue to increase the number of students that are able to participate. And the numbers keep going up, so hopefully we'll have about 25% of students back in the building second quarter, and our staff just continues to find ways to make it work, and I'm just so very proud of them. Any challenge that's put in front of them, they go with it and run, and they do an exceptional job.
And I hear that a lot from folks, that this pandemic has forced some creative problem solving, and I think your team, as you said, has exemplified that. Those community connections, I think, probably growing even stronger, having those relationships and how important it is. What do you see as one of the biggest hurdles you've had to overcome in working with your students during this virtual learning model?
Just the virtual platform in itself. The fall has gone so much better than the spring. And, you know, we were doing emergency teaching in the spring, and now we're actually doing teaching virtually. Our families have been just absolutely phenomenal, though. I can't imagine everything that they're going through with managing work, home, getting their students to engage in instruction virtually, and they're trying everything they can to get their students to access learning. And we couldn't do it without our families and our community, and they're stepping up, and they're doing everything in their power to make sure their children can access learning. So I'm so grateful for them, because it wouldn't be possible without our families.
So a true team effort. And I was very excited to hear that you're going to be having some kindergarten students come in, and your teachers kind of took the original plan to another level And I want you to kind of share why that happened.
Yeah, so we have two teachers that are able to come back and begin in the second quarter to do face-to-face instruction with our kindergartners, doing a half-day program. And at first we talked about how we can maybe shuffle around classes and be able to provide, you know, the virtual option or the face-to-face option. And the teachers said that they didn't want to lose their kids, and how can we make this work so they're going to be doing concurrent teaching so they don't have to lose any of the students in their classroom, and they'll be able to do the face-to-face and the virtual at the same time. And they said that they didn't care if they had to carry around their cell phone with the kids attached to them. They didn't want to lose them. So they just really had that connection with our students and families and want to maintain the community that was built.
And so I have no doubt that the students who will be virtual will be very happy to continue to see their teachers, and the students coming in face-to-face will, I'm sure, be delighted as well to finally get into school as a kindergarten student.
Yes.
In a year that we know virtual has presented many challenges for it. But again, our teachers have been very creative problem solvers. And Troy, what comes through loud and clear in everything you say when you talk about Monocacy are relationships. Teachers and the relationship with the students and wanting to do anything to maintain and keep that relationship, the connections with the community, the families, the trust that you have built in order to say, hey, we're gonna do this together, tell us what you need. And when you talk about food, immunizations, we'll take the resources to you. I know I was there one afternoon when you said, you know, yes, they're supposed to fill all of this out online, but for a lot of our families, that's not where they're comfortable. So we're giving them an opportunity to come in and we'll fill it out on paper if that's what it takes. And it's that if that's what it takes attitude that has just made you a stellar principal, since we were so fortunate to have you and your family come to Frederick. So I want to congratulate you on being recognized. It's nice that NAESP sees what we've seen for the years that you've been here. We are very grateful you are part of the FCPS team. And I know all of the Gators out there at Monocacy Elementary School are very proud of you and thrilled to have you as a principal. So thank you, Troy, very much.
Well, thank you.
Again, national honors, because we do have superstars everywhere across this district and an exemplary leader. Thank you so much, Tracy Hilliard, for nominating him, because we know he is so deserving of this award. And I want to thank you for joining us for Tweet of the Week. Stay tuned, because you never know what's coming next time.